It's a near $39 million makeover.
The stone arch bridge was built in 1883, and it needs to be tuck pointed again.
These guys are the tuck pointers, examining the bridge stone by stone, using saws like this to chip out mortar in between, eroded by our freeze-thaw Minnesota weather, where water is the enemy.
So think about all of those little water molecules that are inside of the mortar. When it becomes really cold, they freeze, they expand. It breaks the mortar up a little bit over time, and then eventually that mortar will start falling apart.
After removing any damaged mortar, crews will repack those spaces with fresh materials designed to last up to 150 years and to slow deterioration.
It's restoring the bridge so that it's, again, keeping it structurally sound for people to use it for many years to come.
But this is no ordinary facelift.
The stones that have the orange spray paint on them, those are the stones that are going to be replaced.
Katie Hong Skuring, MnDOT's architectural historian, says some of the stones, 6 feet long and 2 feet deep, will be either replaced or shaved down.
So when we take these stones off, we're not going to actually take the entire stone depth away. We're only going to take however many inches or, you know, up to a certain number of inches out until we hit that solid stone.
When needed, work crews will attach a stone veneer held in place by rods and posts. No one knows exactly how many stones are in this historic span.
But we know that originally there were 100,000 tons of stone brought in from those three different quarries.
It's a huge job. Crews are using scaffoldings to repair the bridge's sides and these lifts on a barge to work underneath. Inspectors will check these steel tie rods that keep the span's walls from splaying out. The interior drainage system will also be expanded. The first repairs since the stone arch became a pedestrian bridge in the mid-1990s.
It'll always be part of the social fabric of the opportunity that we have to recreate and enjoy the riverfront, to draw us closer to the water.
MnDOT says when this two-year project is done, the bridge will be usable for generations to come.
This is one of, I think, the most monumental bridges in Minnesota. And now to actually see it come into fruition and be rehabilitated is going to be really special.
Yeah, take a look at these amazing arches behind me. Now, some of those replacement stones will come from Mankato, from the same quarry they used in 1883. The idea is to keep on working on the St. Anthony main side until the spring of 2025, then switch out to the downtown side the following fall. The hope is to finish the entire project by the spring of 2026. Reporting live, Richard Reeve, 5 Eyewitness News.